What's going on, Eagle Nation? It's a Monday. It's the 110th day of school. It is the 7th of February. Wherever you may be, please stop and stand. Let us rise together for this morning's Pledge of Allegiance. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the Republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Thank you. Before we get back to our morning announcements, please join me for 10. I started off the day with 60 just to get going. So I got 40 to go. This will add 10 more. Let's do it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Let's see what's going on. The song dedication that you heard today was from Darren Conway. Darren, thank you for that song dedication. That was the Four Non Blondes. He dedicates that song to Calum. He says, Calum, an eighth grader. So Calum, that song was for you. Thank you for that song dedication, Darren. And onward with our morning announcements. We continue our celebration of Black History Month, and we have 3 contributions. So I want to say thank you to the teachers who have contributed, and want to encourage students to also contribute, because today we are going to celebrate Dr. Kizmikia Corbett. Dr. Corbett was someone who used her viral immunology expertise to propel novel vaccine development for pandemic preparedness. There's a lot of very technical language in her biography that I don't understand super well, but what I can simply say is she was largely responsible for and credited with the development of the vaccine for COVID-19, and she is considered a hero of the year by Time Magazine for the year 2021 as being a critical component for this relief effort and in changing the outcomes for people around the world. She has over 15 years of experience in studying dengue virus, respiratory syncytial virus, influenza virus, and coronaviruses. She's garnered several prestigious awards, such as the Benjamin Franklin Next Gen Award and the Saltzman Memorial Award in Virology, which combines her research goals with her knack for mentorship. Dr. Corbett invests much of her time in underserved communities as an advocate of STEM education and vaccine awareness. So today, we celebrate you, Dr. Corbett, and we want to remind all that the theme for this month, for this year's, I should say, Black History Month, is health and wellness. And Dr. Corbett has made a significant contribution to the health and wellness of all. Thank you, Dr. Corbett. Onward. We have a lot of things going on. We are now counting down less than 3 weeks to our 100th anniversary celebration. Things are going to start happening very quickly, and students, we need you to help us get the word out. So we'll start getting materials into your hands so that you can help spread the word, so that we can also put it on social media, put it on Dojo, email, and every other means that we can to get the word out, because we want this to be a community event, because after all, schools are at the heart of communities. And we're going to celebrate together on February the 27th, which is a Sunday. We hope you'll come. I have an opportunity for you to buy t-shirts in advance. For those of you that would like to volunteer to help plant trees and plants on that day. But we'll also have other activities that include screen printing on t-shirts. Be sure to bring your own blank t-shirt and we'll show you how to screen print upon it. We'll also do some rock painting and have some circus arts here. And then we'll be selling some food. And all the food that we sell will go to support our mini med school, which will start in March. So, whatever your reason is for getting interested and excited about it, get interested, get excited, and get on board. We are going to start discussing for our writing theme this month. Remember we did Batman versus Spider-Man? This month, because we're celebrating ourselves, are going to focus on what Emerson means to me. Now, back in 2019, there was a threat of consolidating our school, and it almost closed, but it didn't, in part because of students like you, voices like yours, those that came to the board meeting on that night where there were over 300 people there. And some of the 6th and 7th and 8th graders came and stood up in front of a crowd of people and delivered into the microphone what Emerson meant to them. Back at that time period, we had over 70 students turn in their essays for what Emerson meant to them. But now we're broadening that to say, what does it mean to you now After 2 additional years, after a virtual year online, after another year in the pandemic, and think about all the things that Emerson has meant to you to stay connected, maybe even to stay healthy, to get access to things that you need to make sure that your family has what it needs to just keep right on going, and hopefully beyond survival is able to thrive, if even temporarily. So stay tuned for more. We'll be talking about it more, and we invite you to share your ideas with us. With that, let's get to some words of wisdom so you can get to the business of teaching and learning. And today is on the topic of conscience. Conscience. John Wayne was a great American actor. Listen to what he has to say to us today. There's right and there's wrong. You got to do one or the other. You can do one and you're living. You can do the other and you may be walking around, but you're as dead as a beaver hat. John Wayne is saying that when we do something we know is wrong, it makes us feel bad inside. On the other hand, when we do what we know is right, we feel good. If you're in doubt about what's right and what's wrong, talk to a parent, a counselor, a teacher, or someone at your place of worship. And always, always remember what the great American philosopher Jiminy Cricket says, let your conscience be your guide. With something to think about, this is Mr. Lodato. Mask up today, keep your distance and add 6 inches to a foot, stay in your zones, your cohorts, keep your cell phones put away, and after all that, make it a great day, or not. The choice is yours.